Hello, I'm Marc Desgroseilliers from Technical Support here at Pix4D, and today I'm talking to you about how to reduce processing time. Now, first question, why would you want to reduce processing time? Well, it seems pretty obvious, but by reducing processing time, you'll be able to process more projects and perhaps even larger projects. And to me, I don't think anybody needs convincing that reducing processing time is a good thing. In terms of hardware, I want to give a few recommendations. So for the first step, it's going to be mostly the CPU that's going to make a difference. In the case where you have large projects, say a few thousand images, then having a good CUDA-enabled GPU is also going to reduce the processing time significantly. For the second step, it's mostly the RAM that's going to make a difference. And for the third step, we use a little bit of everything, but one thing that I can say is that if you can have an SSD drive, then that can reduce the processing time for the third step. So now you know if you have a bottleneck in your processing, you have a better idea on how you can improve your hardware perhaps to reduce the processing time. In terms of processing options, for the second step, the first thing I want to say, and it seems a little bit obvious, but if you're not going to use the 3D mesh, if you're just interested in the orthomosaic, then you can unselect it from the processing option so that it's not generated. That stands to save a lot of time. You can also reduce the resolution of the different outputs. However, we do not recommend skipping the second step. The reason for this is that even if you're only interested in the outputs of the third step, by densifying the point cloud, you're going to have more points and thus a better DSM, which is going to lead to better orthomosaics and reflectance maps. So even if you process it at a lower setting, we still recommend processing the second step. For the third step, you can reduce the resolution of the orthomosaic and the DSM to a multiple of the GSD. And then you can also review the different outputs and make sure that you're going to need each and every one of them. Here again, you can save a bit of time by not generating some outputs that are not needed. The last thing I want to talk about is the processing area, because that's one way that you can reduce the area that is computed. So you're going to have just compute for a sub-region of your project. Let's say that you have a building and you have some trees and some grass around, which is not interesting for you. You're just interested in the building. Then you can introduce the processing area after the first step of processing. And then the software will only do the computations for what is inside the processing area. So then you can save some time. Let's see how to do this in the software. As was just mentioned, this is how you're going to introduce a processing area in your project. So first, I will go here and click on New Processing Area. And now I can delimitate the region which is of interest to me. To do this, I'm left-clicking in the area, left-click, and then once I'm done, I do a final right-click to finish the region. And that's it. It's that easy. So I hope you found this video to be helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.